Hello everyone. So today we are going to discuss Katarungang Pambarangay o yung tinatawag nating barangay justice system. So if you look at the bar trend, almost every year or every other year, merong mga questions about barangay justice system or yung referral ng mga cases to the barangay for conciliation proceedings. So based on my experience in law school, medyo hindi ito nadi-discuss in detail at hindi siya napapagtuunan ng pansin. So today at least, we can discuss Katarungang Pambarangay in detail. So yung relevant law is Republic Act No. 7160 or yung Local Government Code of 1991, particularly Chapter 7, Sections 399 to 422. So I suggest kuha kayo ng copy ng RA 7160 and sundan nyo yung relevant provisions habang dinidiscuss natin. Ayan, so just a short introduction. The Katarungang Pambarangay is a community-based dispute settlement mechanism that is facilitated by the barangay. So it covers disputes within members of the same community. So usually, yan yung mga magkakapitbahay or magkakalapit ng tinitirahan. So take note na sa barangay justice system or Katarungang Pambarangay proceedings, bawal ang abogado. Okay? Bawal magsama ng abogado. So take note, for cases that are covered by the Katarungang Pambarangay, it is compulsory for the parties to go through mediation and or conciliation proceedings before going to court. So, baka maitatanong nyo, ano ba yung cases na covered ng Katarungang Pambarangay? So, as a general rule, lahat ng cases dapat i-refer sa barangay for conciliation or mediation proceedings. Except kapag yung kaso or yung dispute pasok doon sa exceptions. So mamaya, i-discuss natin ano ba yung mga exceptions na yon. So pagpasok doon sa exception, hindi na kailangang i-refer sa barangay for conciliation or mediation proceedings. So anong mangyayari kapag nag-file ka sa court without referring the case to the barangay for conciliation or mediation proceedings? So pwede kang madismisan ng kaso. Ayan. So failure to refer the case or the dispute to the Katarungang Pambarangay would mean the dismissal of the party's claim or counterclaim. So that's why this is very important, especially if nagpa-practice na kayo as a lawyer. So just an overview of the process. So yung nangyayari is nagkakaroon ng constitution of lupong tagapamayapa or yung tinatawag nating lupon. So itong lupon, ito yung parang barangay court. Okay? So itong constitution ng lupong tagapamayapa, nangyayari to every 3 years. Okay? So every 3 years, yung na-elect na barangay captain, bubuo siya ng lupong tagapamayapa. So yung members niyan, 10 to 20 members. Okay? So paano nagkakaroon or paano kinoconstitute yung lupong tagapamayapa? So magkakaroon muna ng notice to constitute lupon. So pinapaskil yan sa conspicuous places sa barangay. So ito yung mga places na madaling makita. Okay? So doon sa notice na nakapaskil, merong nakalagay na doon sino yung mga gustong i-appoint ni barangay captain na maging part ng lupong tagapamayapa. Tapos doon sa baba, merong invitation sa mga members ng barangay na mag-endorse or mag-oppose kung meron mang mga hindi nararapat na candidates doon sa listahan. Okay? And kung meron siyang gustong i-vouch, pwede niyang i-endorse. Tapos kung wala doon sa listahan, pwede rin niyang sabihan si barangay captain na consider this person kasi okay yung background niya, etc. And then, after nun, mag-a-appoint na si barangay captain ng members ng lupong tagapamayapa. Tapos, pinupost din yung listahan ng mga pangalan nung in-appoint na members ng lupon sa conspicuous places in the barangay. So, pag meron ng lupon, pwede nang mag-file ng complaint yung mga merong dispute. Okay? So, yung filing ng complaint, pwede yung written, pwede rin siyang oral or verbal. Okay? So, mamaya, i-discuss pa natin in detail itong process ng mediation and conciliation before the lupon and the pangkat tagapamayapa. So, mauuna muna mediation sa lupon. Kapag hindi naging successful doon, magko-constitute ng pangkat tagapamayapa. Tapos doon sa pangkat tagapamayapa, magkakaroon ulit ng conciliation. So parang two levels of conciliation or mediation siya. And then after nun, termination. So kanina, we mentioned na general rule is lahat ng cases dapat i-refer sa barangay for conciliation proceedings before you can go to court. Okay? Maliban na lang kung pasok siya sa exception. So ano tong mga exceptions na sinasabi natin? So the first one is where one party is the government or any subdivision or instrumentality thereof. So ano yung example niyan? So expropriation proceedings. Pwede ring cases or complaint for damages against the city or municipality. For example, naghihintay ka ng jeep, tapos habang naghihintay ka, hindi mo nakita, merong manhole na bukas. So nalaglag ka, and then nagkaroon ka ng injury. So pwede mong sampahan ng kaso yung city or municipality because it is their responsibility to make sure na dapat safe yung roads, walang sira, di ba? So ngayon, pwede kang mag-file ng case against the city or municipality. So pag ganun, since one party is the government or any of its subdivision or instrumentality, hindi na siya kailangan i-refer sa barangay for conciliation proceedings. So the second exception is where one party is a public officer or employee and the dispute relates to the performance of his official function. So take note, dalawang components to. Number one is, one party is a public officer or employee and the dispute relates to the performance of his official functions. So kapag ganyan, no need to refer to the barangay for conciliation proceedings. Now what if yung party is a public officer pero yung dispute hindi related doon sa performance ng official functions niya? So pag ganun, you need to refer to the barangay for conciliation proceedings. Okay? Number three, offenses punishable by imprisonment exceeding 1 year or a fine exceeding 5,000 pesos. So ito yung threshold ng katarungang pambarangay. So maximum imprisonment na 1 year or fine na 5,000. Kapag lumampas ka ng 1 year at lumampas ka ng 5,000 pesos, hindi na yan kailangan i-refer sa barangay for conciliation proceedings. So kapag rape yan, murder, since yung penalty is above 1 year imprisonment, pwedeng diretso na yan sa court. Okay? And then, next exception is, or are, offenses where there is no private offended party. So, example would be jaywalking, di ba? Kasi wala namang offended party dyan. And then, next is where the dispute involves real properties na located in different cities or municipalities. So pag ganyan, no need to refer na din. And then this next exception, ito yung favorite na tinatanong sa bar. So disputes involving parties who actually reside in barangays of different cities or municipalities. So kapag ang dispute, pag yung parties doon sa dispute nakatira in barangays of different cities or municipalities. So, hindi sila same city or municipality. Hindi na siya kailangan i-refer sa barangay for conciliation proceedings. Okay, and then next naman is or are disputes that need urgent legal action. So for example, violence against women and children. Okay, and then where the accused is under detention. So nakakulong na si accused. Okay, and then where a person has otherwise been deprived of personal liberty calling for habeas corpus proceedings. And then where actions are coupled with provisional remedies like preliminary injunction, preliminary attachment, replevin, and support pendente lite. And lastly, where the action may otherwise be barred by statute of limitations. Okay? So next naman is venue. But take note, papasok lang tong venue sa eksena kung kailangan i-refer sa barangay. So parang yung thought process nyo dyan is, number one, ask yourself first, kailangan ba siyang i-refer sa barangay for conciliation proceedings? If the answer is no, then diretso ka na sa court. Okay? If the answer is yes, the next question that you have to ask is, saan yung venue? Okay? So kung yung parties residing in the same barangay, then walang problema, walang kahirap-hirap. The venue would be yung lupon nung said barangay. Okay? So kung parehong taga barangay Guadalupe Viejo yung mga parties, then of course the dispute should be referred to the barangay na kung saan sila nakatira, which is Barangay Guadalupe Viejo. Now, what if magkaiba sila ng barangay, pero same city or municipality? Okay? So pag ganun, yung venue is yung barangay kung saan nakatira si respondent. Okay? Ngayon, what if yung respondents mo more than one? Okay? So pagka ganun, si complainant yung pipili kung saan yung gusto niyang venue. Okay? So, si complainant yung pipili kung saan doon. Okay? Kung alin doon sa mga barangay kung saan nakatira yung respondent, i-refer yung dispute. Okay? But take note, okay? Different barangay pero same pa rin sila ng city or municipality. Kasi if magkaiba ng city or municipality, hindi kailangang i-refer sa barangay for conciliation proceedings. Number three, kapag real property yung subject ng dispute, doon sa barangay where the real property or the larger portion thereof is situated. Okay? So, ayan. Again, different barangays, pero same city or municipality, the dispute will be settled in the barangay where the respondent or one of the respondents reside at the choice of the complainant. And then, pag different barangays, tapos different cities or municipalities, hindi na kailangang mag-undergo ng barangay conciliation proceedings. But, yung parties, pwede pa rin silang mag-agree na hindi, gusto namin mag-conciliation proceedings. But only if yung cities or municipalities nila are adjoining. Okay? Ngayon, if adjoining yung cities or municipalities pero ayaw pa rin nilang magbarangay conciliation, then they may go to court directly. So ito, bar question in 2018. Okay? So tignan natin. Si Daniel daw is a Filipino citizen and permanent resident of Milan, Italy. So nag-file siya sa RTC Davao City ng complaint for ejectment against Dan. So si Dan, resident ng Barangay Dalyao, Davao City. Okay? So yung question is, was there a need to refer the case to the Lupong Tagapamayapa for prior barangay conciliation before the court can take cognizance of the case? Okay? So yung tanong is, kailangan ba i-refer sa barangay or sa Lupong Tagapamayapa for prior barangay conciliation before the court can take cognizance of the case? So yung answer is no. Okay? So the law provides that disputes involving parties who actually reside in barangays of different cities or municipalities need not be referred to the barangay for conciliation proceedings. So dito, di ba? So here, Daniel and Dan do not reside in the same city or municipality. In fact, si Daniel, di ba, nakatira sa US. So therefore, prior referral to the lupong tagapamayapa is not a precondition to the filing of this case in court. Okay. So now, let's discuss, so briefly lang, yung case na Pascual versus Pascual. So this is a 2005 case. So sa case na to, yung complainant, si Dante, permanent resident siya ng US. Okay? So nag-file siya ng case, annulment of TCT and deed of absolute sale against Martha. So si Martha, resident of Vera Rojas Isabela. So dahil nasa US nakatira si Dante, yung nag-file ng case on his behalf is yung kanyang attorney in fact named Sagario. So si Sagario, resident din ng Vera Rojas Isabela. So ngayon, si Martha nag-file ng motion to dismiss. Sabi niya, Judge, kailangan i-dismiss tong kaso na to kasi hindi naman ni-refer sa barangay for conciliation proceedings bago final sa court. Okay, so sabi niya, kailangan i-refer yan sa barangay kasi ako at saka si Sagario parehong nakatira sa Vera Rojas Isabela. So si RTC, ginrant niya yung motion to dismiss, nag-agree siya kay Martha. But when the case was appealed to the Supreme Court, hindi nag-agree si Supreme Court. Sabi ng Supreme Court, hindi kailangan i-refer sa barangay for conciliation proceedings because yung nag-file or yung real party in interest, si Dante, resides in the United States while Martha, the respondent, resides in Vera Rojas Isabela. So dahil hindi sila same city or municipality, then hindi na kailangan i-refer sa barangay for conciliation proceedings. Pwede na agad dumiretso sa court. Okay. So ito naman, any case involving a corporation or juridical entity can go directly to court without going through mediation or conciliation. So pag isa sa mga parties or both parties ay juridical entity like corporation, ganyan, hindi na kailangan mag-barangay conciliation. So kanina, nasabi natin, di ba, na kapag file ng complaint, mauuna munang magkaroon ng mediation before the lupon. Okay? So yun yung unang level of mediation. So yung mediation sa lupon, tumatagal na 15 days. Okay? So ano mangyayari kapag hindi nagkaroon ng successful mediation before the lupon? So mangyayari is magkakaroon ng pangkat tagapamayapa. Okay? Tapos magkakaroon ng second round of mediation before the pangkat naman. What if successful yung mediation before the lupon? So pag ganon, drafting and execution na yan ng written settlement agreement. So paano kapag hindi ka nag-appear sa mediation proceedings sa barangay? So kung ikaw yung complainant, i-dismiss yung complaint and you will be barred from filing the case in court. Okay? So in some cases, pwede ka rin ma-indirect contempt. Kung ikaw naman si respondent, i-dismiss yung counterclaim mo and you will be barred from filing a case in court or from claiming your counterclaim in court. And in some instances, you can also be held in indirect contempt. And then pag si respondent yung hindi sumipot, the case will also be referred to the pangkat kasi it's an indication na wala siyang balak makipag-settle. Diba? So sa pangkat na yung next mediation and then pag wala pa din, court na. So what if si respondent hindi sumunod doon sa mga terms and conditions na pinag-agrihan nila sa settlement agreement? So pag ganyan, you have to distinguish muna or you have to find out kailan siya hindi tumupad. Okay? So kung pasok ka pa sa 6 months from date of settlement, yung remedy mo is enforcement by execution by the lupon chairman. So for example, January 1 kayo nag-execute ng written settlement agreement and then mga March, hindi siya sumunod sa mga nakalagay dun sa agreement. So since pasok ka pa sa 6 months from January 1, which is the date of settlement, your remedy is to file a motion for execution with the lupon chairman. So sa lupon chairman pa yung enforcement niyan. So magkakaroon ngayon ng hearing kay lupon chairman, which should be or which shall not be later than 5 days from the filing of the motion for execution. Now, what if January 1 kayo nag-execute ng written settlement agreement and then December na hindi sumunod si respondent? So that's outside the 6 months. So after 6 months na siya from settlement. So pag lagpas 6 months na, your remedy is to have the settlement enforced by filing a motion for execution in the municipal trial court of the place where the settlement was made. So sa court ka na. Okay, so kung within 6 months, kay lupon, kapag lampas 6 months na, sa municipal trial court ka na pupunta. So, repudiation of settlement agreement. So, any party can protest the settlement within 10 days. So, pagka-execute ng written settlement agreement, you have 10 days to repudiate it. So, kung gusto mong umurong, you have 10 days to do so. After the lapse of that period, the settlement will take effect. So, take note na after 10 days, yung settlement agreement na yan, that will be equivalent to a court decision. So, para na siyang court decision which can be enforced. Okay? So, ngayon, what if hindi nagkaroon ng successful settlement sa lupon? Okay? So, after nun, magko-constitute ng pangkat tagapamayapa. So, parang doon yung second round of mediation proceedings. So, yung proceedings sa pangkat tagapamayapa, 15 days then, but it can be extended for another 15 days kung kailangan. Ngayon, what if the parties or any of the parties failed to appear? So si pangkat chairman, magsaset siya ng date for the absent party or absent parties to appear and explain bakit hindi ka sumipot. Okay? So pag nagkaroon ng successful conciliation before the pangkat, ganun din, drafting and execution of written settlement agreement. And then failure, kapag hindi pa rin talaga nagkasundo sa pangkat, then mag-i-issue na ng certificate to file action. So yung certificate to file action, yan yung ipapakita mo kay court to prove na before kami nag-file ng case sa court, ni-refer na po namin to sa barangay for conciliation proceedings. So take note, kapag kailangan i-refer yung case sa barangay conciliation tapos hindi mo ginawa, dumiretso ka sa court, it can be dismissed on the ground of failure to comply with a condition precedent. Okay, so that's why it's very important to know kung kailangan ba siyang i-refer or hindi. Okay, so like what we mentioned earlier, the written agreement has the force and effect of a final judgment of a court after 10 days from the date the amicable settlement was made. Okay? So 10 days, yun na. Force and, meron na siyang force and effect of a final judgment of court. So certificate to file action, it shall be filled up attesting that no conciliation or settlement has been reached as certified by the pangkat secretary and signed by the pangkat chairman. So it shall be submitted doon sa court or government office for the filing of the appropriate case. Okay? So, ano naman tong arbitration? So, doon sa RA 7160, doon sa relevant provisions pertaining to Katarungang Pambarangay, merong arbitration. So, di ba, ang conciliation and mediation proceedings sa barangay, hindi mag-i-impose yung barangay chairman or yung lupang chairman or yung pangkat chairman, di ba? But, if nag-agree yung party that they shall abide by the arbitration award or the decision of the lupon or the pangkat, then they will be bound by it. Ito yung arbitration clause na tinatawag. Okay? So dito, nag-agree yung party na, sige, kung ano man yung maging desisyon ng lupon or ng pangkat, susundin namin yan. Okay? So kailan pwede mag-agree yung mga parties at any stage of the proceedings? Okay? So either the lupon chairman or the pangkat chairperson can act as an arbitrator. So the parties shall present evidence as to the facts and merits of the case to the arbitrator. So may mga witnesses yan. Parang totoong trial. On the basis of these facts, the arbitrator makes a decision on what he or she believes to be fair or just. So in arbitration, like what we mentioned earlier, the lupon chairman or the pangkat chairman is given the power to render decisions on the dispute with a prior agreement of the parties to be bound by it. Okay? So yung lupon chairman or yung pangkat chairman is given 15 days but not earlier than 6 days. So 6 to 15 days from the date of the last hearing to evaluate the case and issue the arbitration award. So pagkatapos nun, yung secretary, barangay secretary, bibigyan ng kopya ng arbitration award or ng arbitral award yung parties within 5 days. So will the arbitral award take effect immediately? So the answer is no. Okay, so parang sa settlement agreement then, the parties are given 10 days to nullify the decision. After the lapse of the period, the decision becomes final and executory. So kung gusto nyo ipa-nullify yung decision, your remedy is to file a petition to nullify before the proper city or municipal trial court. Yeah. So thank you. And if you have any questions or requested topics, please do not hesitate to send me an email at this email address. Okay?